hello and a very warm welcome to Shanghai for quarterfinals day at the Li-Ning China Open, the 12th and final event of the OSIM BWF World Superseries. Not only the 12th tournament, but also the 5th and final premier event, because this year, for the first time, the BWF have promoted 5 of the 12 Superseries events to an even higher premier status. And there you can see what's gone before and what's still to come. Just the Super Series finals to be played next month, and of course just the top 8 qualifiers from each of the 5 disciplines will reach those Super Series finals. So this, the last chance to try and grab those precious points to try and qualify for the prestigious finals. Well, there's our order of play for today, quarterfinals day, and we're starting with women's singles and the world champion Wang Yihan from China against the unseeded Nedelcheva from Bulgaria. Then more world champions in the mixed doubles from China up against Chen and Cheng from Taipei. Then women's doubles and the All England finalists from Japan, Fuji and Kakiwa, up against the world championship bronze medalists Gutta and Ponapa from India. And then the last of our 5 matches this afternoon will be Simon Santosa and Peter Gaeder. And of course, men's doubles will be the second men's doubles quarterfinal. Ko and Yu up against Tan and Kukian Kiat of Malaysia. So those are our 5 matches this afternoon. Quarterfinals day, and the players coming on to court. First of our quarterfinals this afternoon, and it features the world champion Wang Yihan, gone up this week, yesterday in fact, to regain her spot on the top of world badminton, number one on the world rankings once again. And there is the unseeded Petya Nedelcheva, 28 years of age, lives in Sofia and also spends a considerable amount of time each year in Copenhagen in Denmark. So the new world number one, there she is, up against the world number 18. That's the first of our 5 quarterfinals. I'm Jill Clark, sitting alongside former England head coach Ian Wright. And Ian, we have to tell everybody first of all about a disappointment we've heard just a few moments ago as we look at the fact that Wang Yihan has gone up to number one in the world ranking. The number 2 seeds, though, 46-7, that's a pretty impressive win-loss record for the year. And that translates into 6 finals, continuing having 1 of 5 of them. So to Nedelcheva, world ranking 17, Super Series ranking of 19, just up a couple of places since last year. Well, here's the head-to-head. 4 times they've met previously. The last time they met was at the Super Series finals in January earlier this year. Wang Yihan, of course, has won all 4, and she won that last encounter in 2 straight games, as indeed she's won all of their encounters in 2 straight games. But Ian, just going back to the point that I was making before we saw the court officials there, we've just heard very sad news that Kai Yun and Fu Haifeng, the current world champions and number 1 seeds in the men's doubles, have just withdrawn from that event. That's disappointing.
It is, yeah. They had a very, very long match yesterday, and of course they had a good run in Hong Kong and won Hong Kong in a dramatic final last week, and it looks as though all that effort's taken its toll.
So the Bulgarian Petya Nedelcheva, far side of the court. My goodness, what a good tournament she's had so far. Very first round, she beat the number 5 seed, Yang Jiao, in 3 very grueling games, 21-15 in the decider, an hour that lasted. And then in the second round, she had to play the qualifier, Li-Han, that two straight games, but 21-19, 24-22 in 46 minutes. That was physically draining as well. Now, as for the world champion, Wang Yihan, her first round match was against Japanese player Ai Goto. Two straight games, but 44 minutes for those two straight games. And then against the Korean Sun Ji-hoon. That, again, two straight games, 22-20, 21-19, but 59 minutes in for two games. As we look at Jiang Ning, the current Olympic champion, now coaching the Chinese women's singles players. So both these players in have had tough matches so far through to this quarterfinal.
Yes, and I think that's a reflection of the playing conditions this week, Jill. It's certainly the players have been talking about it a lot overnight, how slow the hall's playing, how slow the shuttles are playing, and the length of those matches would reflect that, I think.
Just emphasising your point, exploring every inch of the court, long, grueling rallies. And a quick glimpse of Wang Shoshian, who was the number one seed. Lost yesterday to the world junior champion, Intanon Ratchanok of Thailand. Just wide. Ian, I think the first time I really took notice of Nedelcheva was at the Olympic Games when she reached the quarterfinal in Athens, I think it was. Is that right?
It was Athens, yep. Yep. Took full advantage, actually beat Tina Rasmussen as she was there in the first round. Tina born as she is now. And went on a good run. Beat the Korean player in the next round, went through to the quarters. These conditions quite suit Petya because she's a very powerful player. She can deal with the slow conditions if she's in trouble in the rear court. She's got the power to get out of trouble in these conditions, which maybe some of the other players lack.
Oh yeah, that's a nice drop shot. Well, she's also done very well earlier this year. Of course, she reached the semi-final of the All England Championships, unseeded, and lost out to the Japanese player Iriko Hiroshi. That was a marvellous run.
Yeah, as I say, she's a very dangerous player because she's very powerful. She's a very, very powerful player. And in her younger years, when she was developing, she was already at 16, 17, the number one player in Bulgaria. And from that stage onwards, she was training with the boys. And I think it shows in her style of play. She likes to be aggressive. She likes to attack the shuttle as much as possible. And she does tend to play a different style of play to a lot of the other girls.
Yeah, quite clearly her best visit to the China Open. It's only her third appearance. This particular event, Nedelcheva. Previous two occasions, 2007 and again last year, lost in the first round. Oh, there you can quite clearly see just how slow it's playing. That was a big high clear from Wang Yihan. Not only wide of the court, but it was woefully short.
Yeah, I'm sure she felt she'd hit that well, and it was actually a good metre and a half short in length and out the side.
Well, the first time that Wang Yihan played this China Open, when she was just 17 years of age, back in 2005, she reached the semi-final. Semi-finalist again last year. The world champion never actually won this event. good rally. And talking of world champions who's never won this event, of course, Kai Yun and Fu Haifeng.
Yes.
And they won't now, because we understand that it's highly probable that they'll retire after the Olympic Games next year in London, and therefore this was their last China Open, and very sadly for them, they've withdrawn from today's quarterfinal match.
As you say, Jill, it's already noticeable how hard these two girls are having to hit the high clears and force their opponents into the rear court. I would say, if anything, today it's playing a little slower so far. Maybe it's due to the fact that the crowd's not in yet. Hall only half full at the moment. I'm sure it'll fill up later. But it's certainly playing slow at the moment.
Trying to give the high serve a bit more oomph. Get it right to the back and overdid it. Ah, that's nice. I was going to ask you, Ian, you've been talking about the fact that we're going to have these long rallies because it's a slower haul. I'm wondering in women's singles whether the racket skills and disguise with the overhead will play more of a part than normal, because, you know, they're not going to get away with hitting many winners from the back of the court.
Yeah, it's a good point. It'll depend on the style of the players. I mean, I think we saw last night Wang Shixian certainly suffered because she's more of a touch player, a more skillful player from the rear court, and really she had very little penetration from the rear court because of the slowness of the haul.
Advantage at the mid-game interval. The current world champion. She's such a good athlete, isn't she? Wang Yihan. Not sort of tactical advice. And when you've got the athletic ability to go with it, it's so much easier to implement those tactics.
Yeah, and there's all in the Bulgarian coach. He's been in that role now for nearly 20 years. One of the big characters on the tour. Great enthusiast of the game. He's certainly done a good job with Petra over the years.
Yes, he tends to get very animated sometimes, doesn't he, when he's sitting watching his players.
That's a polite way of putting it, Jill. A very polite way of putting it. If this gets close, I hope we get some images.
So 11-6, opening game.
Another rally. We see how hard they're hitting the shuttle from midcourt. I mean, in some of the halls this year, these midcourt drives they're hitting would be going out. And that completely beat Petya, but I mean, it landed a metre and a half up the court. Notice that's very heavy strapping on Wang Yihan's knee there.
Yeah. Had that last week in Hong Kong.
That's nice.
Yeah, but you read that. Got in, took it early, and that made all the difference. That's a good angle, very good angle. And that's where Petya does tend to struggle, those short, sharp angles down to the sidelines. She's not got. She's a very powerful player, but not quite got the agility of some of the other girls. There we see an example of that power. Latched onto a slightly short high service. Hit with good power. Not particularly close to the line, but strong enough to get through the defense.
The line. It's an interesting contrast between the two players. 17 career titles for Wang Yihan, 23 for Nedelcheva, and yet Nedelcheva never a Super Series title. Tends to play more of the Grand Prix events and international events in past years.
Certainly in her early years she played the European circuit very heavily. Bulgaria, badminton's not a particularly well-funded sport in Bulgaria, and it was a long time before she had to reach a certain level before she got the money to be able to travel to Asia. So it was a long time before she got the Asian exposure.
And that's where the Super Series has helped so much now, with the new regulations of the top players having to support the Super Series throughout the year.
Yeah, and also Petya now, with the level that she's got, she's also got a scholarship from Olympic Solidarity, so she gets some extra funding, which is available for players from developing nations.
Yeah, good rally. Well worked.
Yeah, again, we see read it early, got in very early. She's got a good touch around the net when she takes the shuttle early.
Just wide, taking it very late at the net there, Nedelcheva.
Yeah, little switch of tactics, smash to the middle there, quite unusual in ladies singles, but took Wang Yihan by surprise.
Goodness, brilliant, incredible net play from Wang Yihan.
That's great agility to get there. Look at that. Super touch from low down. Quick recovery. Able to kill the next shuttle off the top of the net.
And now 9 game points. Converts on her first opportunity. 21-11. Yeah, she will have given Nedelcheva a lot of respect coming into this match, but just 15 minutes for that opening game, 21-11.
На бекхенд страната и стоиш по-назад, защото винаги имаш време да стигнеш напред да вземеш перото. Въпросът е да стоиш по-назад, защото тя ще ти играе диагонал. 90% от случаите. Нека да играе нова, поправата не е страшно. Разбрали ли? Търсиш я на бекхенд страната. Просто търсиш бекхенд страната, не можеш да играеш.
Yeah, I think we saw the tactic a little bit evolving in the first game where Petya was trying to build pressure into the deep backhand corner of Wang Yihan. That was certainly the tactic coming into the game. And I think Sir Orlin was certainly saying that from this end, she needs to go back to that tactic, try and push deep into that corner and then look to take the shuttle early after that.
Taken the opening game, 21-11, current world champion. Yeah, starts well in the second. And it's interesting, Ian, we've talked about the fact that she's regained her place at number one on the world rankings, up one place since last week, and reached the semi-final of the Hong Kong Open, but she's down one place from 1 to 2 on the Super Series rankings. How's that happen?
Well, Super Series only takes into account, so our world championship points won't count on those rankings. That's probably the biggest difference.
Yeah.
That will be a biggest score on a world ranking. But obviously not a Super Series event, so it doesn't count towards those rankings.
Hold and flick from the net, but I guess the key is the fact that she's taking it so early at the net.
Yeah, takes it early, knows she can put some pace on the shuttle there as well, because the shuttle won't fly out of the back as with some other hauls. So she's able to play it very flat and very quickly. Yeah, it's a nice mix. Last time Wang Yihan served to that side, it was the straight clear into that backhand corner. Mixed it up nicely there with the cross slice smash. It's good thinking, good variety. Interesting, isn't it, Jill? Both players using long high serves, and we haven't seen so much of that this year in the ladies singles. It's been mainly short serving, and both these players have tend to use short serve, but in this hall they can't take the risk of the opponent pushing it in quickly behind them, so they're both using the high serve. It's a great net and great lift.
Oh my goodness.
Oh.
Well, had virtually everything.
Yep. And at the end, Petya had almost given up, I think. She just thought, well, I'll just go for something here, and there she goes. Cross court backhand drop. Clean winner. Why go round it?
Remarkable.
I think it's that natural reaction, isn't it, though, Jill, when you see your opponent turning to take that backhand shot from that corner, you just tend to relax a little bit. Certainly Wang Yihan did that there.
Exchange once more. Well, she was lucky to get away with that, was Wang Yihan.
Yeah, that was a chance for Petya. Read it, took it early. The danger. Tried the short serve, was pushed deep into the backhand corner, had to lift high, and Petya found the line with the smash.
Quick glimpse there of tournament referee, Madame Isabelle Jova from France.
Again, Petya trying to build from that backhand deep corner.
That's nice. Super. She's played so many hold and flicks there, just swaying the body, looking as if she was going to play the flick once more. And then just playing the nice little net shot.
Well, Petya just complaining here that she wanted the court sweat because there's sweat on the court, and the umpire said no. Petya's complained and they've called for the referee, which seems a little bit over the top to me. I think the players have got the right at this stage of a match to ask for the court just to be swept very quickly.
Yeah, absolutely.
The umpire trying to get continuous play has ended up with a longer break.
No.
Well, that was very strange to me.
Yeah, extraordinary. Of going cross court. Yeah, there's the tournament referee with one of her deputies.
I don't know what you think, Jill, maybe it's a little bit controversial, but if I was a player warming up and watching these matches now, when I come on, I'd be asking to test the shuttles, because these look very, very slow to me. And I have to say, I think I would... Even as a coach or a player due to come on the court, I think I'd be looking for a slightly quicker speed of shuttle.
Yeah, I'd agree with that. The problem is that I think when you test these shuttles, they don't seem quite so slow. Of course, when you hit a shuttle hard, it doesn't completely collapse, but it collapses a little bit, which means that it initially flies a lot quicker before it sort of parachutes out to its normal dimension. And the problem is, if the shuttles don't collapse very much at all, if they're too rigid, then when you try and hit them hard, they just go nowhere.
Yeah. But there's certainly overnight, a lot of the players in the press were complaining of how slow the hall was playing and how slow the shuttles were.
Yeah.
And in this first game, these girls are giving it everything, and really, they're struggling to hit a length.
Yeah.
I haven't seen a hall play this slow for a long time.
Thank you.
She was just getting some instructions from a coach there, and I don't think she liked them. But then again, it wouldn't be a Bulgarian singles match if there wasn't a little argument between the player and coach. Oh, that's good.
Yeah, that's very good.
Yeah. She's guilty of just being too flat with that lift there, that cross-court lift. Wang Yihan, again, showing good athleticism to intercept the shuttle very early and hit down the line.
Gone wide.
Yeah, nice recovery from Petya, deep in the backhand corner in real trouble, and rather than playing the clear, played the long drop recovery to the midcourt, not letting Wang Yihan get it on the net. Good thinking. Super rally. Yeah, super rally again from both players. Petya's playing a good match, but Wang Yihan's got all the answers at the moment.
Perfect.
Yeah, he's not happy with the play in the diagonal from the front court, giving her interceptions.
It's very interesting contrast in, you know, in coaching styles and coach-athlete relationship in comparison to, you know, Wang Yihan, her obvious respect for her coach and the fact that really her coaches just tell her what to do, whereas there seems to be good interaction between the European coaches. I don't know how you felt as England head coach. Did you like a player that sometimes said, oh, I'm not sure about that, boss, I don't agree with that? Or, you know, what's your feeling on that?
Yes, I do. I like the players to be involved in the coaching. I like to hear what they're thinking. I think it's very difficult to go on court and tell a player what to do without knowing what they're actually thinking.
Yes.
You know, if you don't know what they're thinking, I think it's very dangerous to just give them a tactic.
Yeah, I'm very much with you on that front.
It's a very cultural thing though, Jill, isn't it? It's not just about the sport and about the player and the coach. It's about the cultural relationship between an elder and a younger person sometimes. And culturally sometimes that imposes some barriers on what's possible.
Yeah.
Well, it's a good rally, but Petya's just having to work too hard to win these points, isn't she? You know, she's played another super rally there, and eventually she won this one, but there are no easy points for her at the moment.
Champion Jan Ning, my goodness me, every single inch of that court was explored. I have to say, I've been really, really impressed in this match with Wang Yihan's control at the net.
Yeah, I mean, she's so impressive when she takes the shuttle early, isn't she? Mm-hmm. The position she gets into, if you took a photograph of her coming into the net, you could use it in any coaching manual.
Yeah.
It's perfect. The arms stretched out, reaching to take the shuttle as early as she can all the time. And that gives her the option to hold and play net or flick to the rear court. or as she's done a few times, it play the cross net as well.
Go. There's the curse of the commentator. We're just talking about how wonderful she is at the net play and probably makes an error.
Yeah, but certainly in the last 5 or 6 points, you have to give a lot of credit to Petya. She could have folded after those two long rallies, and she hasn't. She's stuck in there, and she's actually only 2 points down in this game. Oh, that's a great angle, though. Good technique, cutting across the shuttle, bringing it down very steeply. Petya trying to press quickly into that deep backhand corner. I know, Jill, you've got a theory with Wang Yihan that sometimes she tries to take too many shuttles round the head rather than turning to take the backhand, and that was possibly an example there. Got yeah. caught a little bit in between whether to go round the head or take the backhand.
Follows it up with a wonderful angle from round the head position.
Yeah, Petya trying to pressure that corner again, but Wang Yihan was alive to it this time, got round the head, hit the good angle.
Me. Well, she had an opportunity from about three-quarter court to try and play the smash winner. Couldn't put it away.
Well, it's difficult in here, I have to say. And if Petya can't put it away from half court, some of the other girls are going to really struggle, because she's one of the stronger girls. Shot, read that early again, read the cross flick this time, managed to get behind it, bring the shuttle down very quickly and steeply.
Well, having been 4 points adrift at one stage, now just 1 point in it.
Yeah. A bit surprised there when Wang Yihan's under pressure. She likes that cross-court slice. Could have been looking for that one.
China.
Well, the fighting spirit in that rally from Nedelcheva, absolutely supreme.
Yeah, great defense. Looked so she was beaten twice down the forehand wing, just managed to dig it out, stayed in the rally, and eventually Wang Yihan went for too much. Again, the mistake came from that deep backhand around the head corner, though. Really well worked, I have to say. There's good variety there. Kept Wang Yihan off balance with a mixture of blocks and rear court pushes, and eventually Wang Yihan playing the cross drop from late gave the easy opportunity. Good patience, good rallying.
Good determination and back level.
Well, that's the one that a coach has to not to play from below net height, not to use the diagonal from late. And Wang Yihan, so good on that forehand interception.
Return, because Wang Yihan with her low serve played the low serve very deep in court.
She played the low serve and she was looking to go back. I think she was looking for interception rear court. She was looking for the rear court push, and Petya did well to just hold it and play the cross net.
Oh, she's missed it.
Yeah.
Would you believe it?
Again, it's good defense from Petya. Again, looked so she was beaten down that forehand wing and just managed to dig it out again.
Yeah, well. Into the lead. Petya Nedelcheva. Sweet shot from Wang Yihan.
Yeah, didn't try and hit this one too hard. Placed it down a little bit shorter, and that caused the problem.
A golden opportunity squandered.
Yeah, interesting in defense though. Petya not using block defense, she's using drive defense to stop Wang Yihan getting in early on the net, as she was doing earlier in the match.
To be in control, Wang Yihan earlier on in this second game. Now, Nedelcheva has 2 game points. And she takes it the first opportunity with a wild error there from Wang Yihan. Well, this really is exemplifying one of Petya Nedelcheva's real qualities, her fighting spirit, her refusal to give up. And after 40 minutes of play, it's all level. Ian, that really was great fighting spirit.
Yeah, and we saw one or two signs there of the old Wang Yihan. When someone sticks with her, sometimes gets a bit fretful, a bit stressed, doesn't she, at the end of sets? And that was a very poor shot on game point there. I'm sure they're just trying to steady her down and ask her to play with better margins, not try and force the play, because she was certainly guilty of that towards the end of that second set. She was trying to hit winners rather than play the rallies out. And that really suits Petya. Usual type of discussion between the two of them. It's one of those coach-player combinations. They never seem to agree with each other, but they've worked together for 10 years. But of course, the thing you have to remember, Jill, with Bulgarian, of course, it's the opposite way around. The shake of the head is yes, and the nod of the head is no. So it's the only country in the world where that's the case.
Honest, Ian, I didn't think when Petya Nedelcheva was 9-13 down, I didn't think we'd going to be treated to a third and deciding game.
She's a dangerous player. She plays in patches. If she gets a bit of momentum, she's a very, very dangerous player. She's got strong attacking shots. She fights hard. She's found that in this match that the short defence doesn't work because it lets Wang Yihan get early on the net, so she's using a deeper defence, and she's playing a good match.
Yes, and I very much take your point about Wang Yihan looking a little bit nervous now, a little bit ragged, losing her mental discipline. That might help settle the nerves.
Yeah. And under pressure, you want to get your favourite shots into the game, get your confidence back, and I think that's Wang Yihan's favourite, that cross-court forehand slice. A little bit lucky there. It was very flat.
Seemed to move her feet on that occasion. Wang Yihan deep in her backhand corner.
Yeah, again, it's that corner that breaks down when she's under pressure. And Petya taking full advantage of that at the moment.
Yeah, well, there's prime example of taking the shuttle early at the net.
Playing every shot as usual.
Yeah. world. It's amazing because Nedelcheva herself rarely shows much emotion on court, does she? And yet her coach is very, very animated and expressive.
Bit more patient there, patient from Wang Yihan, taking the time, playing with a little bit better margin. I'm sure that's what the coaches are saying behind the court. Play the rallies out, give yourself a meter inside the lines, don't be afraid to play long rallies.
I suspect Nedelcheva actually changed her mind when she was coming forward here.
Yeah, I think she saw how high on the court Wang Yihan was and tried to go over the top. Just couldn't quite control it from so low. Yeah, and there's that favoured forehand slice again. Not going for the line, going for the angle. And suddenly, she's found herself with a commanding lead.
Yes, five straight points.
Good rally from Wang Yihan, though. Very patient. Didn't take any risks from around the head when she was pushed there four or five times. Played the clears. Happy to play the rally out. And that looks the better tactic for her. Just got drawn into being too attacking in that second game.
This is a run of seven straight points now.
Yeah, and it's Petya now, it's the Bulgarian player that's just forcing the game a little bit too much. Going for winners when she's a little bit off balance.
It's gone wide.
Same again.
Well, it's actually 10 of 11 points that Wang Yihan has just won. She was 1-3 down. And was it just that Wang Yihan started to tactically play the right sort of game, or has Nedelcheva gone off the boil?
I think she's just got a little bit overexcited with some of the shots she played at the end of the second, and she's tried to force too much. She's gone for some winners when she's not been well placed and made one or two unforced errors. And on the other side, of course, Wang Yihan's been more patient, playing the rallies out, not being so attacking herself.
Well, the first thing that Nedelcheva has got to do is stop this run of points. Oh, that was going wide. Yeah, oh, she's done precisely as I suggested she needed to. where she hit a couple of green backhands in that second game. Didn't work on that occasion.
Yeah, coach a little bit frustrated there. She played 2 points where she played with good margin and let Wang Yihan make the error from below net height. And then again, just went for a little bit too much with that backhand rather than being patient.
Oh, that's brilliant. Yeah, well, Zhang Ning is obviously saying, look, you've got to be waiting for that round the head push.
Yeah, it's a bit predictable now, I'm afraid. Served her well in the second game, but Wang Yihan playing with a little better margin in this game, not making the same number of errors from that corner, not going for too much.
Oh, that's going well out. Just didn't seem to move forward with any real purpose.
Well out the side.
Down, but not out yet. Yeah, he knows it's going to be incredibly difficult from here. 10-point advantage now for Wang Yihan.
Again, I'm sure all the coaches are saying to the players, it's never finished in this hall. You can get anything back. And that was a good example. Petya stepping in, close to the net, hitting hard. And Wang Yihan still able to get it back.
That Wang Yihan wasn't trying to actually at the last moment get a racket out of the way there. Oh, that's magnificent. Good disguise, good angle, and just no power left in the legs of Nedelcheva. Push out wide and defend that. A very tired looking Bulgarian now. And the number two seed, just 2 points away for a place in what would be her third semi-final here at the China Open. Yeah, you can never write her off though, she'll fight right till the end. Thank you. 11 match point opportunities. First time of asking, and the world champion has shown us exactly why she is world champion and world number one. 21-11, 18-21, 21-9 in the deciding game. And I think it really was that passage of play from 1-3 down in the deciding game. 10 of the next 11 points went to Wang Yihan. And psychologically, that just gave her the lift that she needed, the belief to stick to her tactics of playing out the rally. And there is confirmation of the score. 56 minutes, just 4 minutes shy of the hour mark. And there, Wang Yihan safely through to her third semi-final here in China.